Today I have the pleasure of interviewing Peter Clausi of CBLT. How are you today?
I'm at the mining show, so I'm in heaven. I love PDAC.
Well, we all do, and for all of you cannabis investors out there looking to widen your portfolio, you want to be watching Peter Clausi in CBLT. So let's start with Cobalt. Cobalt and acquisitions, give us the most competitive elements of why they should be investing in CBLT.
CBLT acquired Cobalt assets inexpensively, has done work on them to prove them up, and the price of Cobalt has moved up on the London Metals Exchange since we purchased them. Cobalt is an in-demand metal. It's one of the green revolution metals, and you absolutely need it for the electrification of the world, which we're moving towards.
And of course, the beautiful thing about cobalt is it appeals to people who are interested in geopolitical stocks affected by geopolitical issues and, of course, sustainability issues, right, etc. So let's talk about what's happening with cobalt in China.
Well, nickel, the rare earths, copper, manganese, graphite will all be driven by this electrification of the world. These are all necessary elements for lithium-ion batteries. China saw this well before anyone else. They cornered the rare earth market in 2008, 2009, and currently most of the world's production goes to China. I recently saw a chart on Reuters, I believe, that showed that 51% of the cobalt sulfate market is delivered to China, which means they control the market.
And of course, there's issues with a lot of cobalt coming from conflict areas.
Yes.
So we have a conflict-free mineral area with through CBLT, which you're
right,
working on. It's a clean tech directed critical material. Can you give us any other reason, compelling reason, why you should definitely have CBLT in your portfolio?
Ethical jurisdictions, Ontario and Quebec. Two, easy jurisdictions to work in. One property's in Sudbury, the other is just north of Montreal in Quebec. These are mining-friendly jurisdictions with a lot of mining knowledge and mining infrastructure to make my life easy. It's not like we're working in North Mongolia where they don't have the resources or the infrastructure. Here in Sudbury, you have every miner you need, every tool, every testing piece of equipment is available to you. Plus, we can drive right onto the property, which makes it very easy. Good infrastructure.
You have a sophisticated management team, an excellent board of directors. You've been trying some different business models, you know, a lot of acquisitions, for instance. Can you tell us a little bit more about this?
We did successful M&A. It was very hard to raise money, as anybody in the junior space can tell you. So we bought properties in Ontario, went to Australia, and sold or optioned some of those properties at a profit for the company. So we have not had to do a financing and dilute the shareholders. It's been accretive. Our balance sheet currently has about $600,000 worth of securities in other companies that we've generated from this profitable M&A activity.
So based on some of these deals, maybe the GTA, talk to us about that particular deal.
Our M&A process continues. You can make more money with the pen than you can with the drill bit. GTA decided it was getting out of the mining business, so it ran an open, fair, transparent bid process. CBLT was the winning bidder. We hope to close on that shortly. That includes a 43-101 resource estimate of 800,000 ounces of indicated and 400,000 ounces of inferred gold in Hemlo, starting at surface. So this is the world famous Hemlo gold camp. You can drive onto the property with a pickup truck, and there was formerly a gold mine at this site, so we know the gold is there. It's one of four assets being picked up from GTA. We're very excited about it.
Well, congratulations on that deal. But in addition to that, what should we as shareholders anticipate, say, in this next upcoming quarter or two?
Well, the company intends to start liquidating some of those public company assets it owns to generate cash, non-dilutive to the shareholders. We also will likely try to carry out a flow-through financing at a premium to the market and spend that money wisely in the ground. We will continue with opportunistic M&A activity. I'm not a geologist. I don't fall in love with mining assets. Any asset that's good enough to buy is good enough to sell at a profit. And we are now fielding inquiries about our portfolio of assets from different parties around the world.
Well, Peter, as always, it's such a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's always nice being here.